this one I thought, have you ever wondered why you can get a partial right bundle branch block? And do you ever get a partial left bundle branch block? The reasoning for the partial is that if you look at the two bundle branches, left and right, the right bundle branch has got two fascicles, we call them, which are wire pathways, and left bundle branch has only got one. So when you disrupt the left bundle, you get a complete left bundle branch block. If you disrupt one of the two fascicles of the right bundle, just one of them, you'll still have some right ventricular firing. It becomes an incomplete bundle branch block. And the difference being that essentially, if you disrupt a complete bundle, what happens is, for example, with the left ventricle, the right ventricle fires first, and then the electrical conductivity comes through the muscle to then fire the left ventricle, which is why you've got this widened QRS complex. It's more than, you know, four squares wide, for example. With the right bundle, you still get the rabbit ear appearance in the right ventricular lead, and that can be explained later on in another video. But with an incomplete, you still have a QRS which is of normal stretch, normal breadth. But if it's a complete right bundle branch block, it's wider than allowable, because what happens is initially the left ventricle gets activated. The right ventricle can't through the nerve fibers, but the electrical conductivity comes around the muscle of the left ventricle, hits the right ventricle, then secondarily activates the right muscle. Thus, you get this strengthening of the QRS complex. And the difference is, instead of bang almost both ventricles firing at once, you get bang one ventricle firing and bang the other ventricle firing a split second later, which gives you that broadened QRS complex. So that explains why you can get a partial right bundle branch block, which is generally almost always innocuous, benign, very, very common. We don't worry about it medically. Left bundle branch block, you've always got to worry about it medically, because even you've got to think of structural heart disease as a contributor, coronary artery disease, etc. And some studies show that even in the absence of structural heart disease, it does have a worse prognosis over decades and decades. So you've got to think about the left bundle. Always gets our attention a lot more. Enjoy your week, and see you soon.